Oppression takes many forms, and the oppressors often dehumanize and ridicule their victims as an attempt to make themselves feel okay about what they're doing. But since this rule is followed by practically all oppressors in history, we can draw strength from history and know that total turnaround is possible in one lifetime, our lifetime.
You're 80 years old, and in your lifetime you've seen white invaders protecting their right to hang, shoot and kill natives. You've seen babies of natives being ripped from their families to be raised under government supervision so they'll fit into white society. And you've seen both those laws abolished. You've seen invaders legally taking native people's land, only to be taken to court a few years later and have to give the land back. You've seen sorry books circulate the nation, and you've seen the government formally apologize for the murders and baby stealing. All of this you've seen in your lifetime. And all this didn't happen just because people woke up one day and thought, yeah, I'm not racist anymore. No. So don't be disheartened by those who disagree with us, guys.
We still have racists. We just don't let them oppress us anymore. We're in control now.
Don't demand every cage be bigger. Demand every cage be empty. The oppressors only have power if we let them. And God knows they'll try.
But just as we still have racists who would vote to reinstate genocide, there are still going to be people who want to needlessly torture animals for their pleasure. But don't worry about it, eh?
If we can go from stealing Aboriginals' babies to recognising them as equal citizens with full rights and added grants and benefits in one lifetime, total animal liberation is possible too. They can't shoot natives forever. And they can't rip babies from their mothers forever. History's on our side, you guys. But watch them try to oppress this.